impression from the get-go. Let's see who makes the strongest start here in the first match of this junior girls final. Harimoto style. There we see the ball. Disguises. Less obvious. Oof. This is the team. Foot. It's a very, very technical shot. Strawberry flick. It's renowned for their strawberry flick. Up the 18-year-old with the serve again. She's used the pendulum almost every single time. Importance of this first match. It'll give the second player confidence going into it. In the cadets, so she's a very, very tough player to beat. Lovely length on the pot of the serves. Half long as well. If you can make the touch play half long, it can add awkwardness to your game. But, and there's no reason to say that you can't beat your opponent, even if they're higher ranked or have a bigger reputation. The way he can cover most of the table with it is remarkable. Well, looks like she's going for the shovel serve again. Into the forehand again. And she follows up nicely with the third. Pendulum serve again by Shi with backspin. Well done, Lagasaki. See if the shovel serve can pay dividends again. Look at that. Swaggy forehand fade. Straight past with the serve. Edge ball at the Olympics. Three for the team. But it's two, Mima Ito, Kazumi Ishikawa. Like Sung Ying Sha and Wang Man Yu. That aren't so much older than these junior girls we see here, but again, more time to play those big shots. You could argue a longer distance to play with than down the line. Backhand touch, which could have done to help Shi Shunyang. Oh, it was a forehand just then that we saw. She could give herself two game points here, that would be huge. Look at this. Again, serve. Can she give herself a 2-0 lead? Oh, it's a missed serve from Shi Shunyao. 11-9, just like the last game. That's really got to be salt into the wounds. Shi Shunyao. Not showing so because she moves in one direction, plays the ball in the other. Clean sweeping Chinese players in straight sets. It looked at one point as though Korea could have actually beaten China after Korea won the doubles. She's gone with the shovel serve so often, but it's working for her, so why should she change it? Oof, but with a bit of her own magic. Oh, that was beautiful. She'd love to get 6-4 up to give herself some breathing room. She hasn't really had space to breathe. Yeah! Quick to the Chinese. You can often be beaten by your own pace. to slow. Nagasaki quite troubled at the moment. Shuffle serving. Chinese 18-year-old still bouncing on her toe. She doesn't want to give Nagasaki any more confidence than she already has. Ooh. Oh, a bit of fortune off the top of them by 2-point margins. Could they be the same again? Will that do what she hasn't done yet and convert a game point? Or can Nagasaki throw spanner in the works again? Not this time. Shi Chunyao gets a mark on the board. Loop. Let's see what might have changed. Nagasaki's doing well in the blocking department. There was time. She's just dismissed the ball with that forehand on so many occasions. Point as it comes. Playing against the Chinese player, it's easy to fall into a trap of. Shi Chunyao is going to have to find another gear. Because Nagasaki's been in the driving seat so far. Rather than come up the back of it. Because she'll overhit otherwise. Just a split second. But the meaning behind it. Shi Chunyao's creeping through the door. Get herself technically in the zone. Two more opportunities for Shi Chunyao. And there we have it. Outright receive error and Who Dares wins coming into this fifth set. Be amazing if she could break both serves of Shi Chunyao from the get-go. Can often be more effective than playing it to the open space because your opponent's expecting it. Maybe letting Shi Chunyao attack and then countering could be a different tactical approach. In game, she'd love to convert both serves. The first one. She did very well there, 7-6. In an instant. Both players are hungry though for this. A bit tighter. And there we have it. What a comeback from Shi Chunyao. From the brink of death.